understanding the general adaptation syndrome and how we actually cope with the stress. So this concept of general adaptation syndrome was given by Hans Seyel, and he is considered as the father of modern stress research. So under his study, the issue was that there were various stressors that were given. Now these were in the form of high temperature, insulin injections, or staying them in laboratory for very long period of time. So those were kind of some stressors that were given to the subjects, to the subject animals on whom Seyel was experimenting. And based on the response, he drew a kind of general adaptation syndrome curve. Now what was it? It says that there are three phases, three stages. The first is the alarm phase, the second is the resistance phase, and the third is the phase of exhaustion. The alarm phase is a phase when one enters into stress. So the level of arousal immediately starts to decline. Now, this could be any stressor. As we have discussed, it could be a stressor which could be physical, environmental, psychological, or social. There could be a kind of some loss in the family. There could be loss of job. There could be inability to attain higher education. There could be an internal stress of conflict where there is a tug between a job or a education. So those are all a kind of phase where one enters into the stress situation. Now this is where the activation of the adrenal, pituitary and cortex actually takes place. So adrenal, pituitary and cortex basically takes place, and it triggers the hormone to produce the stress. Now as soon as the stress is there, one gets used to it, and there is a phase of resistance. The stress can be prolonged. Now when the stress can be prolonged, there are parasympathetic nervous system which calls for more care to be taken by the body's response system, and the idea is to confront, to immediately confront any kind of stress that comes in. So any kind of stress that comes in, the person would try to say no, keep it away. And that is a resistance phase. They want to resist it. They do not want to know anything more beyond it. And finally is a phase of exhaustion. Exhaustion is a phase where there is continued exposure to the stress, the same stress, additional stress that could be there, and a situation when a person is no longer able to bear the stress, a state of burnout as we have understood. A state where there is a complete decline in the physiological, psychological and emotional levels. So Hans Seyel talked about this model in how the changes in the level of an individual's phenomena take place in response to a stressful situation. But his model had been criticized a lot because he limited the psychological factors affecting the stress. So what major factors he covered were the real life factors, and those were extreme factors, let's say loss of job, death of someone, or a medical emergency. So he tried to keep the psychological stress at a lower end, and therefore his theory of general adaptation syndrome was criticized a lot. But adhering to the lifestyle, making needful lifestyle changes, changing your diet, exercising regularly, continued activity, low fat intake are some of the ways which actually reduces your stress. The next is psychoneuroimmunology. Now, psychoneuroimmunology focuses on the link between three things. What are the links? It is simply the mind, the brain, and the immune system. So, we focus on three important aspects, and that is the mind, brain, which is the physical entity, and the immune response system. So in our body, we have the WBC. WBC is responsible for what? WBC is responsible for destroying any foreign body that enters into our system. Now this WBC can include or has three types of cells. Those are the T cells, B cells, and natural killer cells. What is the difference between the three? T cells are the cells which destroy the invaders. They completely destroy the invaders. They increase the immunological activity and basically help creating a immunological response to something. B cells are the ones that produce antibodies to fight the infection. And finally, you have natural killer cells that try to destroy all kinds of viruses, tumors that exist in the body or that can harm the body. So there are three criteria under which we have WBC, or three types of cells under WBC. Now what happens? Stress can create a situation of cytotoxicity. It means that because of higher stress, the person can have destruction of the cell, cancer growth, tumor growth. So negative behavior, negative thoughts, associated anxiety, depression, hostility, aggression could lead to stressful situation. When there is a prolonged stress, cytotoxicity could increase in the body. Along with that, there could be irrational fears, mood swings, fits of depression, anxiety, irritability. So all those are some of the major know-hows of understanding how cytotoxicity could be increased. So Endler and Parker gave a strategy to cope with the stress. Their strategy was threefold. The first is, we have to be task-oriented. Now task-oriented means scheduling a time, time management, solving similar kind of problems that you face, and that is how you can actually take your stress, take it as a challenge and find a solution for it. So be task oriented, obtain more and more information about the stressful situation and try to get rid of it. A simple example would be, let's say a person suffers from a disease XYZ. Now this is an immediate stress that he gets to know, but soon he tries to get and collect information. These are the five hospitals that provide good facility, and once he's there, he meets a doctor and thinks that his problem would be resolved. This stress level automatically declines. So this is a task oriented strategy. The next is emotion oriented strategy. Emotion oriented strategy says you must maintain hope. You must keep your hope high and try to control your emotions, control your anger, frustration, and you should not worry about what happens next. So think in a positive direction and try to say, I am definitely going to get out of this situation. So that is an emotion oriented strategy. And the last is avoidance oriented strategy. Avoidance oriented strategy involves denying or minimizing the seriousness of a situation. So any situation that you encounter can be very, very serious, but you just want to avoid it. You want to hide it behind the curtains. You do not want that to be revealed. So that is a avoidance strategy. You simply want to keep that thing away from your mind and avoid it. Do not hear, do not see anything related to it. So that is avoidance oriented strategy. Now, whenever we are talking about coping, we are trying to reduce the stress. So stress relaxation techniques or stress reduction techniques, which includes relaxation, meditation, biofeedback, cognitive behavioral therapies, are excellent ways of dealing with the stress. Along with this, we need to understand how the stress is. So we need to be either problem focused or emotion focused. When I say problem focused, what does it mean? It simply means we focus on the problem, the root cause of it, and try to get rid of the root cause. Let's say there is a plant and there is an infestation because of which there is declining let's say productivity of the plant. So what you do is you simply remove those leaves, you remove the cause, and the problem would be solved. The next is emotional support that could be seen. Now emotional support means I have a plan. I can definitely fight this. I can take over this. So this is a kind of emotional support where you support yourself that yes, I can do it and I will be able to cross any kind of barriers that come in the life. And therefore, we need to understand when we are trying to handle any stressful situation, whether it is it can be resolved through focusing on the problem or it could be resolved through a emotional focus. Let's take another example of COVID scenario. With COVID and lockdown, there was severe impact to many businesses around the globe. Now, one could focus on the problem, but let's say a common man focusing on the problem and saying that I'll remove the root cause of the COVID situation is not practically possible. So what you have to do is you have to find out emotion focused approach where you say, okay, these are just 2-3 months. I'll have to find some alternate way of business. I'll manage with what we have in the next few months and then think about the future. So that is an emotional focused way of fighting with the stress. So how you cope with the stress actually is very, very important, because if you are not able to cope with the stress, that could lead to a situation of exhaustion. Exhaustion, which is emotional, which is psychological, which is physiological, and ultimately this is a state of burnout where you are no more able to take the level of stress that you have. So that is how we essentially need to understand how to cope with a stressful situation.